Some additional things that you can see in this section include the meninges. The pink that you see on the surface right over here, and it's all over this outer surface, represents the pia mater. The pia mater is a thin connective tissue membrane that covers the surface of the nervous tissue, and it follows all the contours of the nervous tissue. So right over here where you have the anterior median fissure, the pia mater goes into that fissure. The blue that you see right over here and surrounding the spinal cord represents the arachnoid. That's another connective tissue membrane. And the arachnoid has a space below it, or between it and the pia mater. This space is the subarachnoid space, which would be filled with cerebrospinal fluid, and this is where you would find the blood vessels which supply the central nervous system. The outermost meninx is shown here as this beige-colored material, and this would represent the dura mater. The dura mater is the tough meninx. So here is the dura mater, and directly on its interior surface you have the arachnoid, and then below the arachnoid you have the subarachnoid space, and then directly on the surface of the spinal cord, following all its contours, you find the pia mater. An important structure illustrated in this model is shown right over here and right over here, the denticulate ligaments. Denticulate ligaments are extensions of the pia mater from the surface of the spinal cord onto the surface of the arachnoid and the dura mater.